Hello guys, the world is ending, so let's make a film. Yeah!
I shook hands with everybody.
Come on, positive.
Face of the medical team, his medical team, he's been moved to the intensive care unit at the hospital.
We're past the peak, and we're on the downward slope.
The United Kingdom has now recorded Europe's highest number of deaths linked to coronavirus.
That's now the highest number in Europe. It's the second highest in the world. That's not success, or apparent success. So can the Prime Minister tell us, how on earth did it come to this?
I was scrolling YouTube, you know, just doing my stuff, just staying home, procrastinating, whatever, and came across Austin McConnell's new video, and he talked about making movies, and he introduced the Quarantine International Film Festival. Basically, it's just challenging you to make a movie, indoors, while you're in isolation, while you're in quarantine. That's in the name, Quarantine International Film Festival. Do you get it? Cool. And I thought, you know what, this would be a cool challenge to do because, you know, I like making movies and I'm bored as hell. I'm going to put some notes down, so this film has to be under 5 minutes. The theme is bear, like an animal, bear, or bear, like I got bear things though. Had the idea of kind of a comedy and romance. So my idea, simply, a guy gets ready for a date. So that was the idea, just a man getting ready for a date. And honestly, I think that works. And in terms of the theme, I guess we can link it to the theme. Link is I got bear problems. So I've got many problems. That's my interpretation of it. I've got loads of problems. I'm getting ready for a date. Like, boom, what do I wear? Do I smell good? Duh, why did she ask me out? Does she even like me? What am I doing? Etc. He gets ready physically and mentally. Now this is the part where I open my laptop because I don't remember this off by heart. We are going to use Dan Harmon's story circle. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. Story structure at its finest. Character. I mean, I don't want to call him Jake because that's a separate universe. A character. So instead of calling him Jake, let's call him Jacob. Because that's a good distinction, isn't it? But they want something. In terms of they want something, he's already got the date. So he doesn't want the date, but he wants to do well on the date. Enter unfamiliar situation. We have a character, Jacob. They want something. He wants to do well on the day. Enter unfamiliar situation. What should the unfamiliar situation be? Well, I had this idea where the girl calls him and they have a talk on the phone or something like that. So that could be your unfamiliar situation. Jacob, he's a bit of a loser. He's a bit of a loser. And he uses self-deprecation humor to get over himself. So he's not that confident. She calls him and says, I can't wait for the date. And that puts more pressure into his head to perform well on the date. Adapt to it. I'll be honest, there are way easier ways of writing this, but I'm an idiot. Fakes. Oh, that's something. He fakes something. He fakes. He has to get off the call, so he fakes something. He fakes. What should he do? What should he do, huh? It's something that's got to be at the moment. And not like, he can't fake an injury, because the date can't happen if he fakes an injury. He fakes out that he's... I've nearly got it. He fakes out that he's... That he's in the shower. He gets what he wants. She explicitly flirts with him. So like he says, "Oh, sorry, I'm in the shower. I'll see you tonight." And she goes, "Ooh, that's hot." See you tonight. Boom, he got what he wants. He's off the phone, no pressure. He gets what he wants. He's still going on the date. He can still perform well on the date. There, he's got what he wanted. He's still going on the date. And hey, she likes him. That's what he wants. He pays a heavy price. Before I was thinking a panic attack maybe. Of just bang, bang, bang. You're going on this date. Bang. You've got this really hot girl that's going on the date with you. Bang. She might like you. Bang. She just explicitly flirted with you. And the thought of you being naked turned her on. Bang. Oh my god. That's more pressure. Oh my god, I can't take it. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Panic attack. Return to the familiar situation. An obvious one would be like the literal one. He's still in the same. He's still in the flat. He could be stalling for time. That could be one. And his familiar situation is... Raw. I don't think I can go through with this. He wants to perform well on the date. That's what he wants. But... you know. He can't perform badly on the date. If he's not on it. Hey. Having changed. I don't know. Maybe something should be a trigger. I don't know what that something is. We'll probably work it out. Later, but something triggers. Hey, she likes you. Be easy, you're fine. Go on a date. It doesn't matter. As long as you're together, you like her, she likes you. Boom. And then, yeah, there we go. He's got confidence. That's the whole story. You see what I did there? It's a story about confidence and stuff like that. Boom. There we go. There's our story. Let's review, shall we? We've got our character, Jacob. He wants something. What does he want? He wants to do well on the day. He wants to perform well. He enters an unfamiliar situation. She calls him and expresses her excitement for the date, adding more pressure towards his performance on the date. He adapts to this situation. He fakes out that he's in the shower and gets what he wants. She explicitly flirts with him and tells him, "I'll see you later," and call ends. Well, he paid a heavy price for faking out that he's in the shower because he has a panic attack from the pressure to perform, because she's just made her intentions very clear that she likes him, and he's not very confident at the moment. He returns to the familiar situation. He stalls and doesn't go on the date. Lastly, he changes by reminding himself that she likes him since she said yes to the date in the first place. And explicitly flirted with him. And that he likes her. And the date, it'll be fine. And he gets his confidence back. Goes on the date.
To begin. How to start.
So it is day two. It is the 25th of March. The deadline is on the 1st. So we've got a few days left. Yesterday, I came up with the story. I came up with the story beats. And then I wrote the first draft of the script. To be honest, it came up pretty good, if I do say so myself. I think I've got all the beats going. I'm still waiting for word back from my friend who I've asked to play Rebecca. You know, it's a vocal role, so it's safe. It's safe. It's the perfect time to film. I might shoot some stuff today. I might not. Depends how bothered I am. This will probably be the last time I film behind the scenes from this camera, because I've already filled up this SD card full of behind the scenes work. I don't think I'll be doing any shooting today. Hello, hello, hello. It's day three of the quarantine film challenge. It's the 26th of March today. So we've got a good 5 days left before the challenge ends, before I have to submit my film. So we're moving on good time. I've just recorded the scene, the first shot of the film. I'm going to film another scene today, me just putting on my shirt. My friend got back to me today. She's down, and yeah, we've got ourselves an actress. So yeah, that's cool. Everything's on course. Day three, that was the setup for the first, for the opening shot of the film. So there you go. There's your behind the scenes content. Right, so it's the 27th of March. That means we've got 4 days remaining to finish filming this and edit it and send it to Quarantine International Film Festival. I think I'm gonna record some things today. I think I'm gonna record the actual panic scene, actual panic attack today. And I did have a little idea of how it's gonna go. So, you know, still I'm gonna be here sliding down that wall. But I had the idea of maybe doing it like a slider. So like the camera's here, taking the wide shot, but then the camera moves like this and gets closer and closer and closer to me here. And you're probably wondering, Jake, you don't have a slider, mate. How can you pull that off? Well, I'm glad you asked, because I think I have an idea. I have all this cardboard here for my medical equipment, all this cardboard. I can cut out the cardboard and put it down here, and then hopefully with the cardboard can swing it with that on the cardboard down on the legs. And for rope, we actually do have some rope. Here it is. This was used as a prop for a short film that I was in the currently making, but had to suspend because of the coronavirus outbreak, unfortunately. So yeah, that's my plan. And the rope will just go on this and then we'll just move it back. Like, I'll be having a panic attack, but, and probably do it one-armed, and then the other arm is just pulling the slider this way. That's the plan. Hopefully it works. If it does work, I will show you. But yeah, it's the plan for today, just to shoot the panic attack scene. Still need to hear back from my friend. She messaged yesterday. Hopefully she messages us again, and we can sort this out. We can do all her phone call scenes, and then pretty much that's kind of the end of shooting, really. And yeah, we've got 4 days remaining. Let's say we've got 4 days. We've got 4 days and a couple of hours, because it finishes April 1st at midnight Canadian time. And Canadian time is before UK time, so we have a little bit more time than everybody else. So yeah, that's what we have planned for today, the 27th of March, day 4.
Two, three, four.
So it's April 1st today. This is the deadline. And there's some scenes I need to shoot. I need to shoot the ending. Well, the phone call's not happening anymore. My friend unfortunately can't do it. So I'll just do it as text, I guess, because I've downloaded like a text template online, so I'll do it as text. It's fine, I can work around it. I'll do that as text. I'll shoot the ending. That's all we need to shoot, and then we need to edit quickly, upload the film onto Film Freeway, and then, you know, submit it all before April the 2nd at 3:59 a.m. because I'm working off the deadline is 11:59 on April 1st, but that is 11:59 p.m. Canadian time, so that means it's 3:59 a.m. on April the 2nd here. So I've got a bit more time. All right, so I've finished filming everything. I'm not entirely happy because well, when we started shooting, it was like on a sunny day, sunny afternoon, It was great weather, but as you can see, if I open these curtains, it's not really looking quite nice outside, is it? And the scenes I did film were in conjunction with those other scenes that were sunny, so it doesn't look great. It doesn't look great at all, and you know, if hindsight's a beautiful thing, because I would have just filmed every single afternoon scene on that afternoon and not left it till now or later to do it. The one day it decides not to be sunny is today, which is annoying, but you know what, we've got to carry on. What's the time? It's like 3:30 p.m. I've got 12 hours to edit this thing and then upload it. Yeah, I finished recording everything, the ending, the texting. That was quite an awkward scene because, like, you know, it needs to be done in post and stuff. But hopefully it will look not too bad, I guess. Yeah, and then at some points I was just considering, like, should I just quit, should I just not continue doing this? But then I realized that's not really the point. The point is just to make something, make a film. Like, it doesn't matter if it's perfect or not. None of the films I've made so far are perfect. None of them whatsoever, but I'm proud of all of them. I'm proud of this. Like, it's not gonna turn out great. Well, at least to me, it's not gonna turn out great. But some scenes are really good. Some scenes I nailed it. And overall, it's like enjoyable. So, yeah. Hopefully, I can just get this edit done. Then upload it and then put it into the Quarantine International Film Festival. Who knows? they might even accept it. I don't even know. Are they going to accept it? Will they accept every single film they get?
Ladies and gentlemen, we got him.
And it's taken ages to edit it. I found out because I think I shot a lot more than what was necessary. And well, the film I wrote, it came up to 5 pages. It definitely wasn't 5 minutes. So I've spent the last few hours editing it down. It's 2 o'clock in the morning. I've got an hour and 59 minutes. I've just started exporting it. Might need to stop it though, because I've put VBR 2 pass and that takes ages. That takes ages, so I might need to do it again, but just do it normally. Sadly, I have to cancel it and do it again with just the 1 pass. VBR 1 pass, and it's gonna take 18 minutes. And you see the time there, 2:06. Man, we are cutting it fine. We are cutting it really fine. Hopefully the upload to Film Freeway won't take as long as this. The time is 3:25 a.m. And I've just sent it. Literally, I've just sent it. I did it. I finished it. I actually managed to finish the challenge. Quarantine International Film Festival. I submitted my film first time data, just in case I don't. Everybody, take care of yourselves. Wash your hands. Stay safe. Love to you all. And thanks for watching. Tonight, I'm going on a date. Yeah, I can't believe it myself. She actually said yes. Can I just say, this cocoa butter right here does the trick. So that's what YouTube supposedly says. I had to use the backup shampoo though. The Lynx, I mean, that's kind of frowned upon online because, you know, it smells a teenager. I mean, I don't know what came over me, but I asked this girl out. This beautiful, amazing girl, Rebecca. And to my utter surprise, she actually said yes. She said yes. She accepted the date with me. With me, of all people. Like, how? I'm gonna screw this up, aren't I? Oh no. Like, I'm not the tallest guy around. Like, maybe 5'1", I guess? And I'm definitely not the prettiest guy around. Hell, there are 3 billion guys way more attractive than me. Yet she still said yes. Like, I just want this date to go well. It's my first ever date, and I really like Rebecca. I mean, her music taste is rad, she acts, she likes film, and she's Northern? Well, technically. She was born in the North, but grew up and lives in the Midlands. She inherited the accent too. Ah, shit. She wants to talk right now. Oh, shit. What do I say? I'm in the shower. Sen, I am so stupid. I mean, I just got out of the shower. I can't talk right now, unfortunately. See you later, though, right? She just text that? She flirted with me. She liked the idea of me getting out of the
You're
shower.
You're not good enough for her. You can't handle her. She's too good for you.
I would kill a whole with a loser like you.
You're not good enough. Small hand, weak. She's too good for you. She's a whole with a loser like you. You are good as a nightmare.
She deserves a real man.
Ugly.
Not a
ugly.
Boy.
Ugly.
Loser.
Ugly.
Loser.
You're
Imagine
a loser.
She ducks down
she
to kiss
like
you,
Jake.
Loser.
You suck. You're 5 foot one, dude.
Hey. She likes you, man. You asked her out. And she said yes. She has flirted with you so many times. And she just a minute ago explicitly flirted with you. She likes you, dude. You'll be fine. Don't worry about it. Just be you. Life moves pretty fast. You don't stop and look around once in a while, you can miss it.